Big relief has come in for the BJP President Amit Shah in the Sohrabuddin encounter case. The charges against him have been dropped in both the Sohrabuddin and the Tulsi Prajapati cases. The brother of Sohrabuddin has reacted to these developments in the CBI court in Mumbai. Let's listen in.
तोता होता है सीबीआई, जिसको सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने तोता बोला है, उस तोते ने बचाया है। बीजेपी का सेंट्रल हुकूमत का पूरा हाथ है इसमें बचाने का। मैं प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस बुलाने वाला हूँ, जल्दी बता दूंगा पूरी बात। और इसको सेंट्रल हुकूमत ने बचाया है पूरी तरह से। हाईकोर्ट जाएंगे, बिल्कुल जाएंगे, हाईकोर्ट जाएंगे, देखे जाओगे तो बहुत बचाव टाइम देखे जाओगे।
Abhishek and Megha reporting on this, but coming to you first, Megha, we understand that the reason for dropping the charges has been lack of evidence.
Well, yes, what the court said today after almost 2.5 hour long judgment that was passed, you know, by the end of it, when it came to the operational part, the court in fact said a couple of important observations that are part of the order. The court said that Amit Shah cannot, accused number 16, that's Mr. Amit Shah, he cannot be charged as an accused in these both these cases, which is Tulsi Ram Prajapati as well as Sohrabuddin and Kausar B's fake encounter cases. Also saying that if the court had to consider the evidences in totality produced by the CBI before the court, then it does not, it is not enough to make accused number 16 as an accused in this case and stand trial. That is, Mr. Amit Shah cannot stand trial in this case. So no charges to be framed against Amit Shah. Please remember that the trial in these cases have not begun as yet. He's been discharged even before the trial has begun, and he's been discharged in a whole
Over a year since the case was shifted to Mumbai and the trial has not begun. Now, Abhishek, you have been tracking this case from the very beginning. Amit Shah has alleged this is a political conspiracy. But on the other hand, we've seen his opponents say that the evidence by the CBI has not been put in.
Well, you see, the whole premise of CBI on which they had based their arguments or their belief that Amit Shah should be an accused was the phone calls that happened between Amit Shah as minister and DG Vanjara and Rajkumar Pandian as police officers of the ATS. Now, the argument on the part of Amit Shah has been that CBI is looking at the phone call records of only 2 months. But if the CBI had looked at phone call records of Amit Shah 2 years before that incident and 2 years after that encounter, the CBI would have itself concluded that Amit Shah was in effect a hands-on minister who loved to be in touch with his grassroots police officer, and that the number of phone calls that he made in that period of 2 months would be similar to the number of phone calls he made before and after that. So according to Amit Shah's camp, and perhaps which has been accepted to by the Mumbai court, the number of phone calls cannot be the basis of connecting Amit Shah with the conspiracy of encountering Sohrabuddin Sheikh and Kausar B. So it seems that agreeing with that argument of Amit Shah's lawyers, the court has given a clean sheet, which should come as a big relief, not just for Amit Shah, but for the BJP and the NDA government as
it
well.
Certainly does.